also. What a beautiful property and a beautiful view of this property I have from up here.
What are you looking at this point? Like, where's your focus?
Right now I'm looking at you on the stage.
That's scary. You don't want to do that. So let's go to plan B.
So for the most part, I'm focused on the wire in front of me. However, I've been blessed with doing this for a long time. As you mentioned, my family started doing this back in the 1780s. Well over 200 years now. So I'm able to look around a little bit.
What is your process as you go through this? Because you're kind of walking downhill a little bit right now, is that correct?
That's correct. So the catenary, which is the engineering term for that downhill swing. Oh, there's a little bit of wind. As I get closer to the middle here, I'll feel, of course, a lot more wind, because I don't have buildings blocking that wind. But yes, I'm walking downhill for the first half. Catenary is basically a fancy term for a smiley face indicator. So I'll walk downhill for the first half, and then uphill for the second. I will tell you it is my preference to walk uphill over downhill. God forbid if I was to slip, it's just like walking upstairs or downstairs. I prefer to slip going upstairs, but those stairs are a little closer for me to catch if I needed to.
He has no harness on.
You can slip all back to the stairwell and not let go.
What's up, baby?
Deal.
So it's a wire.
Crazy.
We're going to put John up there, yeah, okay. We want to thank you and talk to you throughout, yeah, okay.
Control our inner dialogue. physically trembling on the wire. I went back to my place, and I told my wife I was never going to get on the wire again. I was going to give up. I was going to quit. So I remember that conversation, and my wife said, Nick, you sign every autograph, never give up. You do what you do, inspire people that nothing is impossible, and you're going to give up? I'm like, that's not the man I'm married. And she was right. But see, I had to retrain my brain. I had to learn to cast out those negative thoughts, not allow them to take over my mind. And I think all of us are dealing with that, and all of us do in one way or another. We deal with those challenges in life, whether our minds say we're not good enough to do something, we're not smart enough to do something, we're not good looking enough. We all deal with those challenges. So I encourage you, don't accept those negative thoughts. I talked about training in 91-mile winds. I'll never forget when I was walking across the Grand Canyon. I got hit with 48-mile-an-hour winds. Jim Cantoria, an incredibly talented weatherman and a close friend of mine, and he told my dad in his ear, and I also heard him, because my dad was in an IFC, similar to what I have today, listening to you, Jim. And I heard him say, that's a 48-mile-an-hour wind gust. My mind wanted to go crazy. I wanted to go down and grab the water and hold on and wait for help. But see, I encountered that negative thought with the thought that I trained in double that, or nearly double that amount of wind, so I knew I would be safe making it to the other side. I encourage others to do the same thing. Learn to control your inner dialogue. We're faced with this wild pandemic. There are so many unknowns. There's so many people struggling right now. But I encourage you to remain positive. Great things come from a positive mindset. All that and more. What I want people to realize is this is my passion. This is truly what I was made for. It's what I love doing. And I do it to inspire others that nothing is impossible. Again, if I left the thoughts creeping in my mind prior to taking that first step, to be honest, I would never take that first step. So I encourage others again. Never that negativity is positivity. And you make it through any challenge. And it's off any high wire of life.
Good job. You did it.